going to show you how I set up my Skywatcher HEQ5 mount. You need a nice firm level hard surface to mount it on, spread the legs out as wide as we can and align that peg with the north as best we can. You can use a compass for that, or if you know where Polaris is you can use Polaris. Then use a spirit level across two of the joints and adjust one of the two legs in order to get the spirit level bubble in the middle. Once that's done, return the spirit level 90 degrees and adjust the third leg until that is level. And once that's done, the top of your mount is level. Next step is to fit the mount head. Gently put that on and just take the slack off of the azimuth bolts. Now we're going to fit the securing plate, which goes up through the hole in the bottom and has a spreader plate on it to push the legs apart from one another. Do up the main axis of it first, tightening the hand screw at the top, and then tighten the bottom one. You will feel some shifting and jerking in the mount as you tighten this bottom one, that's okay. Just take the slack out of those azimuth bolts. You can see that the azimuth bolts rotate the mount in a horizontal plane. Now we're going to adjust the elevation bolts to get the graticule pointing roughly to our latitude. You have to turn these in an opposing way to one another, so you would tighten one whilst loosening the other and vice versa, just as you do with the azimuth bolts. I live at 51 degrees latitude, so here I'm adjusting the graticule to get to about 51 degrees. Just needs to be accurate enough so you can see Polaris when you look up through the polarscope. Once you reach the right position, take out any slack in the bolts. Now we drop the counterweight bar and lock that off and remove the button from the end of the bar so that we can fit the counterweights. You may need one or two counterweights depending on how much equipment you're going to be carrying. Be careful to do up the thumb screw firmly on these weights because you've not got the protective button in the end at this point. You don't want it falling out and squashing your toes. Think about where you position the thumb screws because you don't want them to snag on cables. And at the earliest opportunity, get that button refitted to the end of the counterweight bar to protect your toes. Now I'm fitting the handset, so we plug that into the mount and insert the handset into the carry bracket. I have a USB cable on mine. Now I'm fitting the telescope. So just do an approximate positioning, not balanced at this point, but we'll just fit the telescope, tightening the two clutches to make sure it doesn't fall. And now it's time to fit the rest of the cables. We've got the power cables, camera cable, various dew heater cables and motor focus control cables. There's also a cable to the base of the telescope for a fan that blows air up through the telescope. Once your cables are all fitted, you may have a dew shield to fit. I fit a neoprene dew shield to the end of my telescope. That can have a significant effect on balance, so that should be in place as well before you balance. Basically, once everything's set up, you can balance your telescope. Start with the RA, undo the RA clutch, and see what the balance is like. Here we're telescope heavy, so we need to move the two counterweights down the bar until we achieve a better balance and lock them off again. Now we've got a nice balance on the RA. Now we turn our attention to the declination. So I'm doing the declination clutch with the RA in horizontal position. You can see here that the telescope is bottom heavy. Particularly if I turn it horizontal, you'll see that the bottom of the telescope is falling, so the telescope needs to be moved up in the mount. It's important to return to roughly to the home position at this point, and as you see there, and then move the telescope so that you don't stress the drive gears, particularly on the RA. So I've shifted that and then I'll take it back into this position and lock the RA clutch and see if that's better. And it's still tail heavy, so we'll go back to the home position again and shift the telescope up on the dovetail plate a little bit more, tighten it off again and test the balance once more. That's looking much better now. And we test it in the vertical position as well. If it's out here, you need to twist the telescope within its rings and return to the home position. So that's all nicely balanced now. Now we'll take the cover off the front and the back of the polar scope and perform the polar alignment. And I've done a separate tutorial on polar alignment, so I'm not going to cover that here. But it's important to turn the deck to open up the hole so the polar scope can see through the mount to do your polar alignment. So this is the point at which you would switch to the other tutorial if you want to know how to perform the polar alignment. Once your polar alignment is complete, replace the covers on both ends of the polar scope. And now it's time to put the telescope and the mount into the home position in a more accurate way. So do this first by turning the RA to a horizontal position, getting a spirit level, place it on the body of the mount, and then adjust the RA until the spirit level bubble is in the middle. And then adjust the graticule on the RA to 12 o'clock. I don't tighten the thumb screw at that point. And then I turn the RA 90 degrees by turning from 12 o'clock to 6 o'clock. And once it's at 6 o'clock, I lock off the RA. Now we do the deck part, so we put the spirit level on the telescope this time, undo the deck clutch, and adjust until the bubble's in the middle. Lock off the deck clutch, and now remove the spirit level and adjust the graticule to 0 degrees. Undo the thumb screws, set it to 0, and tighten them up again this time. Now we can undo the deck clutch and rotate the deck of the telescope round to 90 degrees. And lock the deck clutch, and that's now in the home position much more accurately. So when the mount initializes, you get an initializing message, and that's shortly followed by the SynScan and the version number. That's your firmware version that's loaded into the handset. So you just press enter to clear that, and then you get a warning about never use your telescope to point directly at the sun. And then press enter again, and you're asked to set your longitude. Now you've got west flashing here, and with the two arrows in the bottom corners you can toggle between east and west, and then you can press the right arrow here and change the digits if you wish to. So with the right arrow, left arrow to move the cursor, just type in the digits that you want. And when you're happy with it, your longitude is set correctly, press enter. Same principle with the latitude. If you're just happy with what it says, just press enter, and it skips that entry or accepts it. And then it's got the time zone. Same principle for editing the time zone, how many hours shifted from GMT you are. Enter. Then your elevation. You can look up your elevation using various online apps or phone apps. Entered in meters, and then there's the date. Now be careful with the date, it's month, day, year is the format it wants, not day, month, year. It's easy to get that wrong, so I'm going to put in 07/26/2020, for example. Enter, and then the time, maybe 22:00, and now enter something that's maybe 10 seconds or so after the current time, so you've got time to look at your clock, accurate clock, and then wait for exactly the moment that the time you've entered arrives, and at that moment press enter, and that gives you as good a synchronization as you need between the actual time and what's entered in the mount. It then shows you the time clocking away, so you can check you've done a decent job of that. Press enter, and it asks you if you're in daylight saving. So again, the bottom two arrows, you can toggle between yes and no, and then hit enter. And now it gives you information about where Polaris should be in the polar scope. Now, for me, I've already polar aligned at this point, and I don't use this information. If you want to use this information to do your polar align, you can. So you press enter twice to get through that. Now it asks you begin alignment, ? Yes or no. Now this is about star alignment. So if you say yes to this, you'll then be using the handset to do a star alignment. If you say no, then obviously it won't do that star alignment. But if you want to control your telescope mount from
a laptop using something like Stellarium Scope, then you may wish to do your star alignment from there and not do it from the mount, in which case you would choose two. No. So I'm going to choose that for a moment. I'll come back in a minute and show how to do the star alignment using the handset. I'm then going to press the down arrow to go to utility function, press enter, and then hit down arrow until I see PC direct mode, and then hit enter. So now the mount is set up for being controlled by a laptop through that USB connector. But I'm not going to do that. I'm now going to go press escape to take myself back up through the menus. No longer in PC direct mode, and I go back to the setup, hit enter, and then scroll through until I get back to alignment and hit enter. So if I'd have said yes to begin alignment, or one actually, to begin alignment, it would have brought me to this menu. So you can then choose whether you want to do a one or two or three star alignment. If you're just going to look in one local area of the sky, it's fine to do a one star alignment, so long as you choose a star that's reasonably close to where you're going to be observing or photographing. If you're going to be looking at a number of different places across the sky, maybe better to do two or even three star alignment to get a better mapping of the sky over a wider area. But for the purposes of demonstration, I'm just going to show a one star align. If you do a two or three, you're basically following the same process but on two or three different stars instead of just one. So I'll choose a one star align and press enter. Now it's suggesting Arcturus as the star, but you don't have to use the star it suggests. You can use Stellarium or similar software to check what bright star is going to be visible right now from your mount, allowing for all the different obstructions like trees and houses, and pick a star that's reasonably close to where you're going to be observing. So let's assume we don't want to use Arcturus and we want to use Vega, so I've hit the down arrow and switched to Vega. Then I hit enter, and now the mount is slewing to point to Vega. And once it completes the slew, it will then ask you to center the telescope view on Vega, and that's done manually by either looking at photos being taken repeatedly or with the camera, or by looking through the eyepiece. So we just wait for the slew to finish. That's just stopping now. Now in order to move the scope once it finishes, that's just finished, use arrow buttons center to eyepiece. So we're going to use these four buttons here to adjust where the star is in the field of view. But the rate at which it shifts when we press these buttons is controllable. So you can choose your rate. Maybe a good idea to start with rate 6, for example. And you just hit rate and then the number. And now that sets the speed. Now that 6 is a sort of medium speed. If you want to go really fast, maybe choose 8, rate 8. Now you can hear it's quite a rapid movement. That's really quite fast. Once you get reasonably close, maybe choose something like rate 5 and make your fine tune adjustments. So you've got RA and DEC adjustments on there. Now once your star is nice and centered in your field of view, hit enter. Now because this was a one star align, it's now saying alignment successful, and that's basically the star alignment completed. If it was a two star align, it would now be getting you to choose your second star, and you go through the same process with the second star. So the alignment, star alignment is complete, and we're now ready to go and explore the sky. So we can hit escape to get us back up through the menus up to the top, and now we can press object and we can choose what we want to look at. Let's say we wanted to go and look at Jupiter. We would select solar system, and we can choose other things such as Messier objects, NGC, IC, etc. But we'll choose solar system, hit enter, and then scroll through the planets, Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, found the object we want, and press enter. And it tells us the current alt as of that object. Press enter again, view object question mark, press enter again, and now the telescope will slew to the object. And that's it's as simple as that. Once you're all set up to choose an object from the catalogue built into the handset and slew to it.
I hope you found this useful. Check out my other tutorial if you want to know more about the polar alignment. See you next time.